خلونا نشوف بعض هذه المشاهد. المظاهرة الكبرى لليهود الأمريكيين في السنترال ستيشن أو في محطة القطارات الكبرى في نيويورك. ماذا قال اليهود الضاغطون على يعني إدارتهم في أمريكا بوقف الحرب، وماذا قال أيضا بعض النواب في مجلس العموم البريطاني؟
Palestinians have been the victims of oppression for 75 years, and it has to stop. That's why we're here, to say not in our name. I am older than the state of Israel. And on Shabbat, we have to pray. We have to recommit ourselves to justice. I believe that Judaism and Jewish ethics, this is how I grew up thinking, are about justice, and if not now, when? Now. Peace now. Ceasefire now. President Biden and Blinken, listen to what people are telling you, especially the young people and lots of Jews.
Criminal bombing and obliterating entire neighborhoods is a war crime. Collective punishment and starving a population of necessities is a war crime. Ordering 1.1 million people to leave their homes and forcibly displacing them, that is a war crime as well. Mr. Speaker, I absolutely condemn Hamas's killing of Israeli civilians, and I echo the calls for the release of hostages, but that does not excuse war crimes. And merely saying international law should be followed when it is clearly not being followed is an insult. So, Prime Minister, I ask, how many more Palestinians must die before the Prime Minister condemns Israel for violating international law and calls for an immediate ceasefire?
The use of white phosphorus in a densely populated area against civilians is illegal. Both Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch have reported the use of white phosphorus against civilians in Gaza. Can I ask the Prime Minister, has the British Foreign Office received confirmation of any such reports, and if such weapons have been used against civilian populations in Gaza, what will his response be?
Well, Mr. Speaker, of course we keep everything under review, but I'm not going to comment on or speculate on reports where we do not have full access to information or unable to verify facts.
طبعا ده ريتشي سوناك رئيس الوزراء البريطاني.